So first and foremost, let me apologize to my subscribers for being off the map for the last month. I moved to a new place and also I wanted time to assess the content I want to present to you. I truly want my videos to be of value to you. So that being said, in this video, I want to discuss 7 things you'll want to do to stay healthy and look your best. Now check this out, grown man. As we age, Mother Nature and Father Time starts having their way with us. We gain weight, we lose hair, we lose muscle, our eyesight diminishes, and the list goes on. So we have to pay special attention to our eating habits and fitness to help us battle these physical changes. And the stylish grown man that I am, I got your back. These 7 things I'm going to go into will get you on the right track to not only looking good, but feeling good as well. So let's get this party started. Number 1, get an annual physical exam. Look, when we buy a car, we get instructions that we need to get the car serviced when we reach a certain mileage point. This service lets us know if anything is wrong with the car and services any problems. This is what we need to do with our bodies. Annual physical examinations let us know what's going on with our bodies so we can stay on top of issues, which if left untreated, may make us sick. Now I get it. You're saying, I don't want to go to the doctor just to have them give me bad news. Well, better to find out now if there's something wrong so you can immediately begin treatment than to not know and letting the condition get worse. Make sure you ask for urine and blood tests so you will know the level of some of the chemicals in your body, which leads me to 2, limit your sodium or salt intake. Salt makes things taste so good, but eating it in excess is slowly killing us. Although we need sodium for certain functions in our body, too much salt can wreak havoc. Some of the effects of high sodium intake include bloating caused by fluid retention, which causes high blood pressure, which can lead to heart attack, kidney failure, or stroke. Limit your salt intake to about 2,300 milligrams of salt per day, which is basically a teaspoon of salt. Look at the nutrition facts labels to see how much sodium is in the product you're purchasing. Also, do everything you can to not add additional table salt to your food. 3, watch the sugar. According to WebMD, Americans average about 80 grams or 20 teaspoons of added sugar per day, compared to the recommended 36 grams or 9 teaspoons that are recommended for men. That doesn't include sugar found naturally in foods like fruits and milk. Again, look at the nutrition facts to see how much sugar is in it. The average regular size candy bar has about 26 grams of sugar, and a 12-ounce can of soda has around 36 grams of sugar alone. Too much sugar causes a myriad of problems for your body, to include diabetes, weight gain, mood swings, heart disease, and the worst of all, too much sugar in the bloodstream may cause impotence, and that alone will make you kick sugar to the curb. 4, cut back on the red meat. The USDA classifies red meat as pork, beef, veal, lamb, and venison. Eating a lot of red meat causes high levels of bad cholesterol, which causes hardening of the arteries, a condition that prevents blood from flowing as freely as it should through your blood vessels. This can lead to heart attack and stroke. So you may want to consider eating more poultry and fish, but if you have to have that hamburger or steak, try having maybe just 1 serving a week. 5, drink water. Your body is made of 60% water, so it should go without saying that we need to drink water often. Water flushes toxins from your organs, carries nutrients to your cells, cushions your joints, and helps you digest the food you eat. You probably heard that you need to drink at least 8 8-ounce glasses of water per day, but according to WebMD, that number is around 13 8-ounce glasses of water per day. I recommend you check with your doctor to find out what's best for you, as there are medical conditions where drinking large amounts of water can make the condition worse. 6, get a fitness regimen. Looking good in your clothes is the result of a couple of things: the fit of your clothes and the shape of your body. If you're in good physical shape, you'll look better in your clothes, provided that they fit properly. Get a good workout plan that works for you. That can be regular visits to a gym, hiring a trainer to help you, or you can do what I do. I do calisthenics, about 100 push-ups and 100 ab crunches per day, broken up into 4 sets of 25 throughout the day. I take the steps instead of the elevator, and I cut my own lawn with a push mower, which usually takes me about 2 hours or so. These are just a few things to do to get exercise. Also, get a good fitness app on your phone, such as the Men's Health Fitness app that I use. This app can help you keep track of your steps per day and gives you a great how-to advice on fitness. Just remember, stay active and you can't go wrong. Number 7, take some me time. Now, what do I mean by me time? I'm talking about an hour or two per day to reflect, meditate, and de-stress. You need time to just think and plan your next big move. I typically get my me time at about 4 a.m., meditating for about 30 minutes and knocking out my 50 push-ups and ab crunches. I enjoy my hot shower and shave at that time as well. Of course, I go to bed early so I can get at least 6 or 7 hours of sleep. So that's it, guys. These are the 7 things you'll want to do to stay healthy and look your best. If you enjoyed the video, please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. If you know of someone who can benefit from this video, feel free to share it with them. Leave a comment below and let me know what you do to stay healthy and look your best. And as always, be stylish today.